starts. Two or three years ago, I was reading a story. It was the Eloise Ready to Read trilogy. Eloise, in the 1970s, was a smoker. She used to smoke chalk for fun. So it's a little controversial. She's a spoiled brat. She lives in some hotel in New York City on the tippy top floor. There was a movie. So Eloise was kind of interesting to me as I'm reading this story. And it turns out I have my own Eloise, as you can see in the picture. They are, on any given day, spoiled brats together. So we're reading the story, and the story's progressing, and Eloise is having a math lesson with her private tutor, whose name is Philip. It was very interesting, because then I was reading about math, I was excited about it. So Philip is asking Eloise, "Eloise, what is 6 + 5? Eloise is mocking him. She's saying, "Philip, what is 6 + 5? Ugh." And so the story goes on, and finally Eloise says, 5 + 6 is the same as 6 + 5. I'm like, holy hell. Eloise has demonstrated the commutative property of addition. This is amazing. My daughter, on the other hand, who was 3 or 4 at the time, was less than thrilled. But I'm like, this is wonderful. The commutative property of addition is demonstrated in some little book by like a kindergartner. This is amazing. This is great. And then things took a turn for the worse, because the next page was Philip's reaction, and he literally says, "Oh, Eloise," and he's so disappointed and distraught and upset, and I'm like, what the hell is Philip's problem? Like, let's get a new tutor. Philip literally hangs his head in his hands, and I'm like, God, he really is smarmy. This is annoying. So then I got worried. I got worried about the world outside of my classroom. I got worried about the world in general. So the next thing I decided to do was Google, which you should never do when you're worried. But I Googled it anyways, like Americans and math, and these two images came up. And I was just like, oh, this is worse than I could have ever imagined. This is so bad. And so then I started thinking automatically, like, what can you do to make things better, personally? Like, what can you do? So I immediately thought of the Standards for Mathematical Practice, one of my favorite things in the world. And then I started to think about how to rewrite the ending to that Eloise story. And so this is my ending, and I would have said, this is wonderful, this is great, you've demonstrated the commutative property of addition at a very young age, and now you'll probably be successful in algebra and beyond. Eloise, this is wonderful. At this point, my daughter was like, I want a new mom. Can I request that? I'm like, no, that's not going to happen. And I really see the power in SMP3, construct a valuable argument, critique the reasoning of others. The verbs of that practice are particularly powerful because when we can engage with each other, parents, teachers, students, administration, about standards for mathematical practice and construct valuable arguments and critique the reasoning of others in math, it's exciting. So my challenge to you is to rewrite the ending of your own math story in the work that you do every day with students, parents, teachers, but especially students. This is what it looks like when Camille, who is my daughter, and I engage in SMP number 3. I also told my hairdresser, you better make my hair look exactly like that today. And it's a lively conversation, and it's a lively conversation that I have with my colleagues. And what my colleagues are telling me is that they've seen a shift recently in getting the answer out of the way. Earlier it was like, what is the answer? That's all we care about. And now it is like a focus on student ideas, academic discourse, discourse between students. My teachers and staff say they really like opportunities to actually do math and engage in math and have multiple conversations about more than one answer or the same answer. And then that made me think about relationships. And relationships on lots of different levels. And what is the relationship between learning, engagement, and discourse? And then, after the whole entire speech, before I did all the slides, I said, oh, you need to Google how to do one. So Google said, for Ignite, just do 3 things. Talk about 3 things, and those are my 3 things I love in no particular order. And you can tweet me, you can email me, you can ask me why I blog at betterknowacupcake.com. And if you ever want to read something and be like, why is that? What? Weird. She's actually typing that. Read the blog. Thank you so much.